Hello viewers, welcome to UNautonomous College. Today we are going to discuss about a new concept that is known as security in JC part. We know that in a previous section we are learning what are the different criteria, how to develop a JSP code, but today our most essential and more powerful topic that is known as a security in JSP. We know that each and every field we require a security. Without security, you are unable to do anything else what is related to our online background, because you know that in our online background, we have lots of frauds and lots of unauthenticated access in our secure data field. So in this topic, we are going to discuss what are the different ways through which you can adding secure features in our JSP part. Now we can focus on a slide. Here in this slide, we are going to discuss what are the related features are related to our security, and that security somehow related to JSP and Sublet and HTML, whatever we can say. But today we are only focused on what are the security features are related to our JSP part. So in this topic outlines, we are going to discuss what are the related features of introduction, then role based authentication, then form based authentication, then examples. Next, we are going to discuss what are the real use of that security in our JSP part. But here, the Java server pages and sublets make several mechanisms available to web developers to secure applications. So if a user want to develop a Java page and server page, in that moment both things can be performed through JSP or Sublet, but in that time we have some mechanisms, and that type of mechanisms helps to develop a web page in a secure field, and that secure field somehow related to our current generation topic. But that topic is the most important thing to be flexible way to run in our JSP server application. So here the resources are protected and declarative by identifying them in the application deployment descriptor and assigning a role to them, because you know that whenever resources are protected and declaratively by identifying them in the application deployment descriptor, in that moment we are getting a one XML file. We know that each and every descriptor file must be related to our topic, and that related topic is always depends on our XML file. XML means extensible markup file. In that extensible markup file, it is using as a descriptor in our JSP part, and that XML file is stored in our, that is known as a one library file, and that library is contains more than one XML relevant documents in this section. So here we are generally assigning a role to them, because you know that whenever user want to process more than one records, and each type of records are processed simultaneously or synchronously, which are stored in our computer system. So here the several levels of authentication are available, that is known as the ranging from the basic authentication using identifiers and passwords to sophisticated authentication using certificates. Because you know that whenever user want to process a site, in that moment a user can put more than one secure features to making secure their site. What are the different ways we can say? General ways is known as we are setting user ID password. That is one way. Another way is known as user can put some captcha. By using that captcha, we can easily recognize that person is a robot or human being. So according to that also, we can process our websites, and also we are using some general codes and some patterns to making some sites for secure processing. So these are general ways through which you can process our JSP in secured manner. In the next slide, we are going to discuss what is the real use of role-based authentication. Because that role-based authentication is always based on one feature, and that authentication mechanism in the Sublet specification uses a technique, and that is known as a role-based security technique. This role-based security technique gives an environment. Through that environment, we can add some features, and that features provide a one secured environment. So here the idea is that rather than restricting resources at the user level, you create roles and restrict the resources by role. If a user want to giving one environment, and that environment is known as a secured and one type of restricted environment which can give the protections to their resources in a specific order, in that moment we can take the help of this role based security features. So you can define different roles in file tomcat users.xml, which is located of the tomcat's home directory in configuration file. An example of this file is shown below. Then how to create this role-based authentication in our JSP part? Here we have some codes. First of all, we are designing a one XML format. That XML version is known as a 1.0 encoding, is part of UTF-8. So here we are taking the help of two tags, that is known as a Tomcat users, because we are using a server that is named as a Tomcat, Apache Tomcat web server. That's why we are taking the help of this Tomcat users tag. In that Tomcat users tag, we contain sub tags, and that tag named as a role tag. Here that role tag contain an attribute that is known as a role name. In that role name, we can put some name. It is a name. This type of names can process that site or process that server. So here the first name is a Tomcat, second role name is a role one, and the role name is a manager and admin. And here we have some role, this type of roles can perform, but here we can set the user type. User type means which type of users can access this kind of web pages or JSP pages. So here if a user want to set their own security by using this user tag, and we can take the help of this user tag with an attribute named as a username, we can put some value that is known as a role one, and taking the password that is known as a Tomcat, and roles that is a part of role one. That means this role one can process through a password that is known as a Tomcat, because we have four type of roles we can perform, and that roles can taking a one part that is known as a password section. In that password section, user can easily set their password according to their requirement. Each and every time user can process in same password or different type of password. If a user want to put like this features, like just you can say here Tomcat, password Tomcat, and roles is also same Tomcat. This in the next part that is known as a role one, username is known as a role one, password here is a Tomcat, and here we have a roles that is known as a same role one. That means that role one can process their JSP page through this password that is known as a Tomcat. In this next, we can say user name, and that username we have a name that is known as a both. Both means by using same password, more than one user's name can be processed. That may be Tomcat or roles. And another tag is known as a username with a one name that is the admin, and there is a password that is known as secret, and we have a role that is known as admin or manager. Similarly, these two roles can perform their processing through this username admin and password like secret. That is a general way we can process the same site by taking the help of single username, otherwise more than one username, it is also possible. But somehow this role-based authentication mechanism is the one best way to handle each and every field of their software section, or we can say website development section. So you can define different roles in file tomcat-user.xml, because this tag helps to design a XML file, and that XML is known as a metadata. Just we can say it can keep some information which are related to our own JSP page, because these informations gives an environment through which you can easily process more than one records in a specific order, and that order is always depends on a specific type of user logic. Whatever user can develop a XML, it must be essential required for development of that JSP page. If that logic is not equivalent with the user intention, then it is a, gives a wrong result at the time of processing. So these are some codes which are related to our user relevant information processing section by setting username and password. In the next slide, we are going to discuss then what are the real use of these two parts. This file defines a simple mapping between the username as well as password and role. Because in the previous slide, already we have three roles playing, that is known as a username, then password, then role. These two, three parts helps to process our sites according to user requirement. So here we can say that is like, notice that a given user may have multiple roles. For example, that is known as the username, and we are taking the both is in the Tomcat role and the role one role. So here we have the way of processing. Just we can say we are taking the help of this Tomcat, because we have some role named as a Tomcat, as well as you can say role one, and manager, then admin. These are the helper of this JSP page setting. So if once you have identified and defined different roles, and that different roles is always based on security restrictions, can be placed on different web application resources by using the security constraint tag element. in web.xml file available in web-inf directory. Whenever user want to develop this type of application directory, and that type of application must be stored in this web-inf directory, means web information directory. That means those fields are related to our secure features, and that secure features environment must be stored in this web-inf directory. So, in the next slide we are going to discuss what are the real use of this web.xml file. So, here first of all we can take the help of this web app means web application tag, then dot dot means we have put some extra points in this section, then we are adding a tag that is known as a security-constraint tag. By using this tag we can also take the help of another sub tag that is named as web-resource-collection tag. So, inside that tag we can take the another sub tag that is known as web-resource-name tag. In that name tag we can put here secured book site and we can close that tag. Then we can also put our URL pattern tag. In that URL pattern tag we can put the secure statement whatever you want to use it. So, we can close that URL pattern, then we can set HTTP method with a name as a get, and we can close that HTTP method tag. Then we can start another HTTP method with post tag, then in that we also need to close that HTTP method tag. Then overall you can close this web resource collection tag by using forward slash. Then we can start another tag format that is written as a AUTH means authentication hyphen constraint. By using this tag we can put some extra relevant descriptor files, like we can put a description about our JCPs let only managers use this app. Then we can close that description tag. Then you can start like role name with a name manager, and we can close that this authentication constraint we can close. Then we can finally close this security constraint tag. Whenever the user can close this security constraint tag, then we are getting another environment which is related to this security hyphen role tag. In that role tag also take the help of that role name manager, and that is also closed by using this role name, and simultaneously this security role also closed through this pair tag that is known as forward slash security hyphen role tag. Then we can set here another three tag like login hyphen config. This tag also contain another sub tag like AUTH hyphen method. By using this tag we can put some name, and that named as a basic, and that basic is known as authentication method name. Then we can close this login config tag. So, it is a general way through which you can put according to user requirement. Then finally, we can close these options which are related to our XML file. Then finally, we can close this web app tag. Whenever user can close this web app tag, then we are getting an environment, and that environment is a secured platform. Through this secure platform we can easily and flexible way to execute each and every field of application. So, in the next tag we are going to discuss slide, if the above entries would mean any HTTP GET or POST request to the URL masked by secure would be subject to the security restriction field. So, a person with the role of a manager is given access to the secure resources. So, the login config element is used to describe the basic form of the authentication. Whenever user want to going to describe what are the different config elements related to a topic, and that type of config elements must be described in a basic pattern. So, what are the pattern which is already mentioned in their slide? If you try browsing any URL including the forward slash security directory, then the following dialog box will be displayed asking for username and password. If you provide a user or admin or password section that is known as a username as admin and password is setting as a secret, then you will have access on the URL matched by secure, as we have defined the user admin with manager role who is allowed to access these resources. So, whatever resources we are using in our computer system, we can take the help of this admin or secret part. By using this two or three part we can closing each and every field of application. So, these are some fields which are related to our topic. So, in the next section we are going to discuss what are the real use of this form based authentication. So, when you use the form authentication method, you must supply a login form to prompt the user for a username and password. The following is a simple code of the login.jsp page. and this helps to create a form for the same purpose. If a usernet is not aware about this tag information, then we are getting an error. So in that form based authentication, we can write some code that is known as HTML tag. In that HTML tag, we can start body. In that body section, we can put an attribute that is known as a busy color. We can set the busy color of a form. Then we can start like form tag. In that form tag, we have a method with that named as a post method. Then we can start action, and that action must taking a one name of a specific JSP or any Java servlet relevant file we can put here. So then we can start like tuple. In that tuple, we can put login and password section. In that login and password section, we can put some user name and password. By using these two section, we can easily create a page, and that is page named as a submit page. By using the submit page, we can easily and securely perform their tags according to user requirement, whatever user can put their secure platform. Simultaneously, we can close this form tag and this body tag. Then according to that requirement, we can finally close this HTML section, which is probably related to our using accessing environment. So according to that requirement, we can put here, like here you have to make sure that the login form must contain the form elements named as a J underscore username and J underscore password. So whenever user can put these two section, the action in the form tag must be J underscore security underscore check. The post must be used as a form method. So here that post is known as one method name, and that method name must be processed according to user requirement, because you know that user have two type of method, that is known as a post method and the get method. At the same time, you will have to modify the login hyphen config tag to specify the authentication method as the form, which is already described in the next slide. So here also we are going to describe what are the real use of this web app tag. Here the web app tag also writes some techniques. In that techniques, we are going to give some error specific JSP page which are linked with our JSP section. Then we can start web hyphen resource hyphen collection. In that tag, we can put your web resource, then name, and that is known as a secured book site, then URL pattern that is secured, then HTTP method, we can put your get and post. Then we can close this web resource collection. Then we can start authentication constraint. Then we can put here a description. In that description tag, we can write some descriptions which are related to our managers use this app. So we can put also role name, which is known as a manager. Then we can put close that role name according to user requirement. Then we can put here authentication constraint. Then we can overall close this security constraint feature. Then simultaneously, we can start this security role tag. In that tag, we can put here role name, that is known as a manager. Then we can close this role name. Then we can also start this security role tag. In that tag, we can put this tag inside this security role tag. So in the next part, we can start like a login config. In this login config tag, we can put some method name that is known as authentication method name. But that authentication method name must be written like form. So here that form gives an environment. By using that environment, we can add some two different JSP files. That is named as a login.jsp and error.jsp. This login.jsp helps to process like our login page, and that error.jsp page helps to process our error page. Whenever user can trying to log in a page, if that page is not successfully opened, then automatically the controller of JSP engine can forward their control to this error.jsp page. Whenever that form error page is continued their processing, then we are getting an environment, and that environment is a secure platform. So that secure platform very reliable and very flexible way to process their each and every field. So here we can close this login config tag. Whenever that login config tag is closed, then we are never getting another way of processing to process each and every field of action. So if a user is not aware about it, then we are getting lots of error at the time of processing. So in these are some ways through which you can process some relevant information which are related to our topic. According to that relevant information, we can generally process some relevant technique, and that relevant technique is related to our some process. So that process somehow related to our GSP and Sovereign technique. If a user is not being flexible to process this kind of security features, it is so difficult to handle it. Now we can focus on the slide. So in this slide, already we can describe. Now when you are trying to access any resource with URL with secure feature, in that moment you are getting this method. In that method we are getting, that is the part of that is a J_security_check action. It uses some internal mechanism to authenticate the caller. If the login succeeds and the caller is authorized to access the secured resource, then the container uses a session ID to identify a login session for the caller from that point on. So the container maintains the login session with a cookie containing the session ID. Whenever that ID is being created, then user is successfully getting an environment. So this environment somehow related to our topic. So the server sends the cookie back to the client, and as long as the caller presents this cookie with subsequent request, then the container will know who the caller is. If user is aware about it, who is the caller is, then we are getting a secured and just we can say reliable environment for processing their JSP page. So here, if the login fails, then the server sends back the page identify the form error page setting. Here the JSP, just we can say JSP security check is the action that applications using form based login have to specify for the login form section. So in the same form, you should also have a text input control called like JSP_username and password to processing each and every field of their JSP page section. So when you see this, it means that the information contained in the form will be submitted to the server, which will check the name and password. How this is done is a server specific. So these are some secure features we can put our JSP page to making our JSP more efficient and reliable at the time of processing. If a user is not aware about it, then it's a great error for a specific type of environment. In that environment gives a fault at the time of server installation or deployment process. So these are some related topics today we're going to discuss about the security features of JSP. If you have any type of doubt or confusion, please do try to send some queries through our YouTube channel comment box. Okay, final thank you. Have a nice day.